Onyx batteries and chargers. Onyx sets the standard in battery power and battery charging. All the power and features you need to win.
Oh no, my camera doesn't work. Ah, there I am. Hey everybody, welcome to the show. Big Squid RC Live. This is show number 21. We were giving Jeff a hard time that if he does that, his face would stay that way. And I believe it may have actually stuck. So we'll have to see if he... Right, we'll just go to Jeff first. Jeff, introduce yourself.
Hi.
You're supposed to say, I'm Jeff, or something.
Hi, I'm Jeff.
Awesome. Greg.
Craig, Crazy Ramp Builder guy.
Adam.
Hi, Adam the intern.
Yoo-hoo! And you guys know me, Brian. Tim is unavailable tonight. We were hoping we'd get him on air, but couldn't. We also were hoping to pull on the newest guy, Kevin, but he's having some technical difficulties, so hopefully next week. We'll see what happens. And it is thundering and lightning here like crazy, so if everything goes dark here in the near future, feel free to just carry on without me, because it's getting pretty bad out there. Anyway.
You're the host.
Oh, yeah, that might be bad, right? It's on a UPS. We'll see how long it lasts.
Is your internet connection on UPS, Steve?
I think so. I think I connected everything I thought would be important. So instead of having like an hour, I've got like 3.5 minutes. Both computers, you know, both monitors, the fridge, it'd be good to go. So let's see. Yeah, big storms everywhere. Trying to think what we want to cover tonight. Oh, hey, I'm going to do this up front real quick, and I will remind you guys after the show. I think the giveaway today is going to be stickers for everybody. So if you are watching live right now, but only live, so like as soon as the show is over, we'll give you like 5 minutes, and then that's the cutoff. If you're watching live and you send an email to pics@bigsquidrc, so P-I-C-S at bigsquidrc, we will figure it out and send an email and a picture of some sort of RC vehicle that you have. That's all we care about. And we'll give you some stickers for your ride. So I think that'll be pretty cool. We'll give away a ton of stickers and make everybody happy. And we'll see how many people actually write in. So good luck with that.
It's 10 p.m. Central Standard Time.
Exactly. Time. And it's not. It's 9 p.m. Central Standard Time.
No. When the show ends, it's 10 p.m.
Yes.
9:30 to 10 p.m.
You guys have till about 10 p.m. Central Standard Time. So you'll have time after the show. So don't panic now. Watch, we're going to lose like all of our readers. They all just quit out. And they're like sending off emails, or all of our viewers. They're all gone. So you'll have time after the show. All we care is a picture of your RC car. And yours, please, not like one you found on the internet. Like, we have contests. Like, send us in a picture of your car, and I'll get a picture with like a Big Squid logo on it, like from the webpage. And it's like, dude, I know that's not your car. We put that thing up. So send us a picture of your ride, or at least like your neighbor's ride or something. Something. Let's hop over to some news here. Except I don't have my news ready to go, but I'll put the picture up anyway. America's Best RC Sale. So head over to Best RC. Those guys are having their yearly enormous sale. It's pretty cool. They knock a ton of prices off of a bunch of rides. So that's pretty awesome. If you've been waiting.
It's usually not just rides either. It's accessories.
Oh, no, it's like helis and planes and everything. So
yeah, you can usually find
that's definitely
deals,
big news.
Especially on electronics, servos and things like that.
Yep, definitely for sure. Speaking of the whole Hapago Best RC sort of thing, they've got their new X100 SSL and the other one, the SS. So it's basically a small little Uber acrobatic heli. The cool thing, I think, for us is awesome LEDs, you know, on the top and the bottom of the blades. So that's pretty neat. There's a video on the webpage. You can check it out, see it in action. That's pretty cool, you know, very Basher-like. And for all you Uber 3D pilots, you can 3D in the dark if you want. Because that seems safe, right? Yeah, it seems totally safe. Just 3D in the dark. You'd be good to go.
Well, the LEDs on the bottom side of the rotor are different colored than the ones on the top. So you can tell which way it's flying.
Right. And that'll be easy. Yeah. When you're like, when you're doing this, burnt, 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 and there's like one red circle compared to the green circle.
It's totally easy.
Uh-huh.
Yeah.
All right. I'm assuming that means, like, you're going to be the first one to fly 3D in a black, all-black room.
I can't fly at all.
We're going to lock you in, like, a 10x10 room with one of these things and be like, all right, flip it. Let's go.
I can flip it. I'm pretty good at flipping it.
I'm sure. Probably
the ceiling, too. And a couple walls.
And you.
Yeah.
I'm sure. You can see it here. The mystery box this week. Let's see if I can. Is actually the new Real Flight. I think that's 6.5. I just picked it up. Even works under Windows 8, which is crazy. We've been doing a lot of flying stuff lately with helis and planes and all sorts of stuff. And I keep handing the controller off to 3D Bill. And 3D Bill flies it and does all this stuff, then hands it back to me. And I fly it, and it goes, and he rips the controller back out of my hand. And so I thought I'd pick that up and see if it helps any of my piloting skills. We'll see how that goes. So what else we got in the news? Let's cut over to Adam for a little bit. Adam, tell us about your rock crawling adventure you had recently.
All right. Sunday we went out to Dallinger's Pumpkin Patch, and there was a big off-road scale RC competition there. There was a lot of people there, a lot more than they thought was going to show up. I competed with three of my trucks. I took second place in the 2.2 class with my Axial Wraith.
Yay! We don't have Tim for our sound effects. Yay!
And it's not just a regular Axial Wraith. It's got normal AX10 axles under it. So it's narrower. It gives it more clearance. It does a lot better off-road.
Cool.
I ended up winning a $50 gift certificate.
Wow. Where's the gift certificate to?
LC Custom Crawlers. It's like a guy that makes stuff for crawlers.
Cool.
And then we competed with the Axial Rubicon.
Nice.
It got more dirty than it did get the job done, but it did pretty good.
That's good. Do you wash your stuff ever?
Yeah, I just wanted to get pictures.
Cool.
But there's a lot of people there, and normally when I go to competitions for crawling, they're not really welcome to everybody. They have their few that they're used to, and then the rest of the people are all outsiders, and they're treated like that.
Yeah, totally.
We went to this competition, and everybody was welcome. It didn't matter if you just bought the truck and you didn't do anything to it. They didn't care. You could be a young kid or an older guy. They didn't care. They were very patient, and just, it was a good day with all fun.
Cool. But, very cool. Actually, I think that's pretty awesome that they let everybody in, because I was doing crawling for a while there, and did pretty well, I think. You know, won a couple of comps and stuff like that, and then came back like the next year to the place that I had just been competing in the previous year, and they're like, "Oh yeah, your truck isn't legal anymore." And I had like a stock Axial. You remember that? Mm-hmm. And, like, it was, you know, I didn't do anything to it, and they're like, "Oh no, it's the new rules. That is an illegal truck." And it's like, come on!
Yeah. The rules for this were basically just tire size.
That's cool.
So when you run a 2.2 truck, it got ran up against other 2.2 trucks. Didn't matter on the wheelbase or anything like that.
Hmm. So did anybody have anything totally whacked out, custom, insane, or?
Not really. They're pretty basic for the most part.
Were they supposed to be scale?
Yeah.
Like, were they supposed to look scale?
Right, yeah, you got different points. It didn't matter if it did or not. It's just you would get more, like, points so that you it would help you with getting a better score. The more real it looked, the easier it was for you to win.
Okay. That's cool. You got to give more of a heads up next time. Because, like, last time you were like, hey, I'm going to this thing, and I'm going to this event. We could have posted it on Big Squid or something for those guys to get the word out a little quicker. You should yell at them or something. So that's cool. Congrats on the second place. That's awesome. Except for the serious lack of Big Squid stickers on that truck. I think it was probably okay.
Yeah, I don't really have much anymore. I kind of gave them all away. But.
All right, where's the disconnect button on this thing?
You're fired.
Yeah, no doubt, right? It's cool. The other thing I saw was, like, they had water and mud and everything else. And I remember, like, the last time I was doing the competition stuff, everybody would be like, oh, man, my Shelf Queen's got to get dirty. Oh, that's not cool, you know?
Yep, so some of the people were like that. They didn't want to get them dirty. So, like, when you'd come up to the mud while you're going to the trail, they would give you a penalty for you to carry it across the water so you wouldn't get it dirty.
Awesome. That's cool. I'm glad you braved it out.
Yep.
Got a little dirty. It's good.
One of these days I'll have to get a rock crawler and come with you.
Yeah, exactly. Sure. Dude, I probably got several you can borrow.
One of these days I'll have to get a plane ticket to Chicago and join one of you guys for something.
Hey, don't make that threat, because you know the ticket will be on its way, and you're going to end up doing iHobby. You're like, hey, Jeff, come on down. We're having this big crawling bash. It's going to be awesome. I'll pick you up at the airport. You're going to be like, hey, where are we going? And just ends up, oh, yeah, by the way, you're doing this show.
Don't worry, Jeff. I'll give you the bottom bunk.
Yeah, Adam's always looking for a roomie when we do events, so.
Gross.
In other news, lots of people have been putting out Durango stuff recently. We just got that. We had the sneak peek, which was really cool. We'd like to thank the ST Racing guys over there checking in with us, and they gave us like a day or two early on their Durango hop-ups, so that was pretty awesome. Everybody else just got the press release later, so thanks to those guys. So if you've got like a Durango you're looking to hop up a little more, they got you covered for sure. Let's see what else we had in the news. Oh yeah, we had our March Bashness winner, so we had the Traxxas Slash actually pulled out the win. Did we talk about that? I don't think we talked about that. So they actually pulled out the official win, so that was cool. But I'll keep it short because something in my head says we already talked about that. So
yes.
I don't have the picture for it, but RDRP also released some Durango stuff. They released like an extended Durango chassis. So it's like everybody's hopping on the Durango bandwagon suddenly. So if you're a Durango fan, you guys are set, because everyone's covering you. Also in the news, the Team Associated RC 8.2 RS, the ready-to-run nitro buggy. It's basically similar to their previous release, but it's got, you know, a little bit more hop-ups and your standard Associated next-gen sort of thing. We'll see if any of us gets one of them or not. It's a pretty hardcore racer, so I don't expect it to be floating around the office anytime soon. This one goes out to Cubby and Tim, who were just dying over this thing. They thought it was like the greatest thing next to sliced cheese. I guess. Which was the, and I got into a big argument with him because I was like, dude, seriously, this is not, you know, the most recognizable car in the world. And, you know, they were all like, oh, it's totally the most recognizable car in the world. But that being said, it's still pretty cool looking. Like the fact that somebody came out with, you know, a Terrell RC car, you know, and it'd be neat to see how it handles. Like, does it handle any better? Does it, can it really take the turns, or is it just get in the way of, you know, everything else?
I want to build an Emax like that.
I'm surprised you don't have an Emax like that.
Four tires in the front, two in the back.
Right.
Four 1/16th Erevo tires on the front.
And this body.
You make that thing a drifter, you'd have tons of control.
Except you'd need six-wheel drive.
Right.
That'd be impressive.
Everybody's commenting about how ugly it is, and
I
often agree with them because, you know, Tamiya did one. They just released one a couple of years ago, a few years ago maybe, and it looked a heck of a lot better. This one is just a poor representation of this car.
Yeah.
Did they make it in real life?
Yes, they did. That was
yes, they,
see? That one's for Tim and Tubby. Who said it was the most recognizable car. Our own Adam the intern's like, I've never seen it before in my life.
It's based on a real car from like the 1970s Formula One series.
I didn't get that email.
I'm totally looking it up though now. So you're gonna have to
It came out before you were born.
Yes, it did. It's the
Terrell P34, I think.
Yep.
Before or after sliced cheese?
See if I can save this picture. Please hold. Totally doing this. All right. Whoops. Hold on. I can import this. Really, I can.
First ran in 1976.
Oop, that's not it. Hold on. Okay, almost there. This is where we put the stall music in.
76.
What yeah, did David add?
There we go. So there's
wow.
There's a picture of the real one sitting somewhere.
Wow.
Or one of them, anyway. There's a few.
Yeah, it looks really funny with the dude sitting in it. You should have got a picture with the dude sitting in it.
Oh, yeah. Hold on. Hold on. I can do this. Oops. Well, that one looks like a toy version. Google Images is failing me right now.
Go to... Just search for Terrell P34 and go to the Wikipedia page.
Oh, hold on. I got one. Aw, it's not the whole body. Boo. Let's see if this one does it. You guys can talk while I'm stalling.
Blah, 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 blah.
You want me to That's talk about my Five Below find?
Oh! Wait, hold on, I got the car. There you go.
Yeah.
They made ones with bigger front wheels, too, I want to say. Like, the other pictures I've seen have had the... Not the tiny donuts on the front.
I like the tiny donuts.
But anyway, it did exist in the real world, and I told Tim and Cubby and that it didn't like make that big of an impact on anybody not concerned with F1, but I'm sure that both will chime in here shortly. I'm surprised Cubby hasn't hopped in already and like totally just reamed me for it.
Well, it only ran for like 2 years, I think.
Yeah.
See what Wikipedia has to say.
I think it did well, but...
I think it would have been cooler if they just put, like, mat tracks on the front of it.
Spin those at, like, 50,000 RPM. You'll be fine.
Or just four of those rear tires. Just four big, huge flex.
Alright. Let's see. I didn't fire up any other exciting news stories.
Cubby says he's not wasting the time to come in here and school with some Formula One.
Tell Cubby I appreciate it.
It would be a waste of time because I don't care.
I definitely appreciate him not coming in and schooling us on F1.
Sorry, Kevy. It just wasn't that recognizable.
Somebody wants to know what the big red blob is behind Adam.
Big red blob? That is a poster of the G-Made R1 Rock Buggy.
And one of these days we're going to get Adam off of a 56K modem and onto a real connection so you can see that.
It looks okay now. Like, it looks okay on my end. I don't know. As long as he doesn't move, it's perfect.
Mine too. Look at how nice it looks. I got that from the lovely G-Made representative at iHobby.
Awesome.
She was very nice.
Yeah, G-Made was digging you.
Nobody can understand you, Adam. Your microphone issues are cropping up.
Does he seem bad to you guys? He seems alright to me.
I can barely hear him.
Really?
I'm not going to say nothing.
Alright.
I'm just going to let it go.
Alright, tell us what your find was this weekend.
I bought a Squid USB splitter for $5. And it is awesome. Just they only make it in blue.
It doesn't really look like a squid to me. It looks like something else.
Careful, kids watch this show.
Yeah. That's why I didn't say it.
Oh, the legs are bendy?
Yeah. And one of them is super long.
Oh, for your USB. That's awesome.
Yeah. And a splitter.
Totally dig that. Does it light up or anything?
There's a little red light on the top.
Cool.
But I'm going to paint him red.
Oh.
He's going to have a big squid sticker.
Awesome.
Yep.
That's a good find. I'm going to have to pick one of those up. let's see. Anybody got any questions out in Chatland?
Yeah. Where did the big squid RC name come from?
Oh, man. Are there any other questions?
That question.
The short version is, in college, for some unknown reason, like, all my friends used to call each other Squid all the time, and be like, hey, Squid, what's going on? Hey, Squid, what's up? And that sort of thing. And, when I was going through company names and stuff, I wanted to be, like, pretty original and not include the word car or something in there, and you know, just try to come up with an interesting logo and name and stuff like that. And I was like, well, Squid might not be bad, but nobody'd really get it. But I try it, and an artist friend of mine came up with, like, kind of a cool logo. And I was like, well, Big Squid maybe. And then, you know, I actually tried to go with just the Big Squid for, like, the URL and everything. Some guy wouldn't sell it to me. So it ended up being Big Squid RC. I know. So it ended up being just Big Squid RC, but I think it works pretty well. And what's great is, like, you know, at trade shows and everything, everybody remembers the name and the logo, and, you know, it worked out pretty well. So that's the short version.
And then short, they asked, edited, where did the name come from?
Uncensored version. What I just said, that's where it came from. Like, everybody calling each other that in college, so I just went with that. That's my story, and I'm sticking to it.
RCCarDriverAction.com was already taken.
Exactly. And I figured there might be the chance that we might do something else besides drive. So, like, all those people that are called Car Action and Driver, and all they do is do boat reviews and planes, doesn't look as cool. So, yeah, that was my thing.
Everybody likes it.
When is Arma coming out with option parts for their new vehicles? Totally, right? I don't know what's going on. They were supposed to have a bunch of stuff coming. Like, we're still waiting for that four-wheel drive. I haven't heard from the Armor guys in a while. That's actually a good call. So I'm going to call them tomorrow. I'm going to forward over to England and be like, hey, what's going on? So I'll see if we can get Armo to step it up a little bit. I know what Jeff's laughing at. Yeah. No, it's hilarious. So, I will totally see what's going on with Arma. So, yeah, they've been really quiet for a while. I don't know what's going on.
Are the brushless ones coming yet?
I don't even know if they ship. Like, it's been that quiet. Like, they mentioned them, but I don't even know if they're shipping. So, I don't know.
They had them at E-Fest.
They did, but I don't know if they were for sale.
No.
So hopefully that thing comes soon. And the four-wheel drive. I want four-wheel drive. What the heck?
Adam, did you talk your mom into your big squid tattoo yet?
I think it's going to happen. I think it's more Adam than his mom.
Not really. I don't really care, but...
You don't care, and we could totally make that happen. You guys could get matching ones. It's like when you stand next to each other, like the tentacles go from your arm onto Craig's arm or something. And
when you put them together, it says best buds forever.
I sent Brian a good design the other day.
Yeah, Craig keeps sending me some awesome pictures of squid tattoos. But I don't think any of those we could actually show on this channel.
Now I know what you're doing.
That woman's arm is pretty cool.
They looked awesome. They looked really cool, but I don't think we could get away with showing them. But they're definitely cool. And I think Craig needs to get one with Adam. I'd probably make Adam go first.
Really?
Oh yeah,
I'll get one like an inch by 2 inches.
An inch?
Yeah, that way I can cover it with a Band-Aid if I need to.
You can go farther than 2 inches with a Band-Aid.
Yeah, they make those really big ones.
Yeah.
Why is your whole arm bandaged? I don't know.
Hey, you just gotta wear long sleeves.
Hey, if they don't like if they don't like your big squid tattoo, then they aren't real friends, my friend. That's all I'm saying.
I'm not worried about friends. I'm worried about family.
Oh, family.
Family.
Well, whatever.
Family comes and goes. Friends are forever.
Your dad owns a fab shop. He might bring out his blowtorch.
Right. We'll take care of that thing real quick. We haven't really been talking plane stuff, but this just showed up. The new Tiger Moth from FlyZone. It's a ready-to-fly plane, little biplane. Should be pretty cool. Comes with a tactic controller. Can you guys see this at all? I don't even know if it's
kind of this. There's a little glare. A
little bit.
Is this right? Is this good? So it comes with a LiPo battery and the double A's and everything you need, so... Looking forward to getting this out there. Except it's been raining for like 5 days in a row here. So
you're just showing everybody the porn that was on your monitor.
Did I really? Oh, shoot.
Yeah, the reflection was in there.
Does the reflection show it? Oh,
yeah.
I think it's...
Zoom in a little bit.
That big squid tentacle porn that you had.
It's all the manga. So, yeah, if it stopped raining, I could get some flying time in, which would be cool. So... Hopefully. Although I'm pretty sure I'll be calling 3D Bill for the hookup. You fly it first, tell me how good it flies, and then I'll fly it and see how durable it is. It's usually how those go.
Hold that back up again, because I don't think you were on the big screen.
Oh, sorry. Oh. Let's see. How's that?
Are you selected?
Yep. Here. And on the back... You can see it comes with the tactic radio and the double A's and the little tiny LiPo. Totally ready to fly, you know, from the folks at FlyZone. So, So looking forward to it. Should be cool.
How much is one of those going to be?
They're relatively cheap. I want to say it's like $90, ready to fly.
What?
That's awesome. Yeah.
Exactly. What? Let me look real quick.
That's crazy. You're crazy. FlyZone, yep. Habico, or Horizon? I think it's
Habico.
Habico.
Tower Hobbies. So the almost ready to fly one is $79. The ready to fly one is $99. So.
Awesome.
Still awesome. Comes with a tactic radio and everything. That's great. So. Definitely looking forward to some flying action. Any other questions going on? What else is up out there? Someone says paint it Red Baron style. Totally, that'd be great.
Too bad we live in Illinois. We could put fireworks on it.
I got some bottle rockets.
I was going to say, just because we live in Illinois doesn't mean we can't put fireworks on it. Or haven't put fireworks on other stuff.
We do not promote breaking the law in Illinois.
Fireworks are totally true.
Bottle rocket engines. Same
right.
Thing.
All right. Yeah, do not break the law. It's not cool.
I don't know how that would fly, like, over in Brian's neighborhood, though.
Yeah, my neighborhood, not so well. Dude, I fire up a nitro car, and, like, 50 neighbors come out, and they're like, hey, what are you doing?
So, do you live
so then I go back in,
people?
And then the 5B comes flying out the garage, and they're like, oh, come on!
What, I'm trimming my hedges.
Exactly.
Driving to the gas station. Premium.
Exactly. Fill her up. Be sweet. Let's see. Anything else going on? What's going on in Craig and Jeff's life? We heard what Adam's been up to.
Oh, I've been busy working nothing. I haven't done nothing on RC for 2 weeks.
Boo. You got to start getting your track ready. Yeah, you talked about coming to Chicago. We're coming to Colorado. We're going to come race the track.
Don't lie to me.
Dude, don't tempt us, man. We will come up there.
Your couch looks comfortable.
Still waiting for you guys to come to the lake so I can do Craig's world record hydroplaning across the lake.
I'm going to be there.
We're doing that here. You're going to have to come in for that one.
We were going to come here and use my boat and my lake.
Oh. Your boat would help. And your private lake would help.
I'm giant private lake.
Exactly. That'd be awesome. Yeah, we got all sorts of water sports planned for coming months, so looking forward to that.
Oh there, Brian.
hey. Can't take you guys anywhere. Jeez.
What's up with that the new Helion monster truck? Helion.
Oh, the Invictus?
Invictus.
So the review is, it's actually done. Cubby turned it in today, but I haven't had a chance to, read it all over. The whole senior editor thing, I haven't had time to edit his interesting spelling techniques and or grammar that there is. But I think it did okay. You know, it wasn't too bad. It definitely, you got to go LiPo with it. It comes with like a 9.6 volt nickel metal, so it's basically 8 cell, and it's just not enough power to move that good size of a monster truck the way they've got it geared and everything. But we threw LiPo in it, and it snaps right to life. It's 10 times better. So for all you guys thinking about it, definitely you've got a LiPo in your future if you're picking one of those up. So. But the review should be up shortly, as soon as I can get to it. I like the guest squid. That thing's awesome.
This thing's so cool.
There's no sideways gym, so we'll take the squid. All right, so before we cut out, before we bail here, you guys, we are giving away stickers, remember. So if you came in at the middle or whatever and didn't hear the beginning, all you have to do is send a picture of your RC vehicle, any RC vehicle, we don't care. Send it to PICS at Big Squid RC, and we will send you free stickers. But you only have till 10 p.m. Central Standard Time. So you have like 20 minutes. So if you're watching like the replay of this, it's too late. Don't bother sending in your picture. But we will send free Big Squid stickers to everybody who writes in right now. So as soon as the show's over, go snap a picture of something RC and we'll give you some cool stickers to throw on there. Any other questions before we call it a night? Or any other comments? Anything exciting going on?
Do you want them to send their mailing address too there, Brian?
They could. It'll make it a lot easier. I think it'll speed it up, the process, probably. if they send in their address, that would be good.
We'll just throw some stickers in a box and
put them in an envelope, and I'll be like, these go to Fat Joe at yahoo.com. and like, you know, we'll see if they show up.
We'll email you a scanned sheet of the pictures. You have to have them printed.
You have to print them out. I'll send you the AI and PDF files. You can take them down to your local sticker maker and print them out. You're good to go. Yeah, I didn't say I'd actually mail them real stickers.
Yeah.
we're going to send you these pictures of stickers and a wallpaper.
Do you have some stickers handy there, Brian?
I'm sure I do. Hold on.
I do somewhere. Well,
I usually do.
I have them all in my...
Hey, it's Sideways Jim! That's awesome. What's up, Jim? Good, what's going on? We... We appreciate that. We really do.
Yeah, well, you know, it's a nice show.
Thank you. Thank you very much. That's awesome.
No, I just want to say that Carl
event
was pretty cool last Sunday that he went to, and we were there, we were spectating, and it was a good time.
Cool. Yeah, for sure. I was yelling at Adam. He didn't give us the heads up.
Yeah, right.
we probably could have sent 30 more people out to that place. So.
Adam's dad looks nothing like Justin Bieber.
It's awesome. Later. Hey, Adam. You realize that, like, if you ever can't make it, Sideways Jim needs to do the entire show without you.
Okay. Just sideways like that?
Yeah.
I think he just pants out after a while, though.
Yeah, I'm not sure how he does that. It's impressive.
His head was getting a little red there.
I do have some stickers. So we have, like, stickers that look like this.
Hair now,
and they say Big Squid RC on them. And then we have stickers that look like this, but we've got bigger versions as well. So, actually, you guys can't see that. There you go. Focus.
We have bigger versions of the Big Squid.
Yes. So we've got all sorts of stickers, and we'll throw a bunch in an envelope and send them off to you guys. So that'll be cool.
I have a question.
Wait, you have a question?
Yeah.
You have to put it in the chat window for Jeff to read it.
Yeah.
My computer's too slow.
Yes.
I make wall vinyls of like 10-foot by 4-foot Big Squid RC logo that sticks on the wall.
We have giant vinyl banners, but I don't know if we have the
football player things.
Right. Do you want like the big head Big Squid sticker?
Yeah, fat head.
Fat head.
Totally, right?
A fat head.
I'm getting a fat head of Adam.
Squid sticker?
Really?
Yeah. Craig, actually, remember he brought those Basher stickers to iHobby. We put them on the ramps. Those things were awesome. But that's actually good. All right, if I give you a giant 6-foot banner, you got to replace your G-Mate picture in the back.
Deal.
Sweet. And it's going to have a picture of Adam, the intern, too. It's going to be the fathead size Adam.
Sweet. Yep.
Or that's sideways Jim. We totally just get his head on like the side of your wall, so he's just always in the back there. That would rock. All right, take a picture of sideways Jim later. We'll have to make that happen.
Wow.
Everybody still likes Craig's green wall.
Need something so, up behind there, some stickers.
Something.
What?
You just slap Big Squid stickers all over it. Just cover it.
Right. Or like two Pong paddles. And like, you know, he could put his head back and forth or something. Like, Pong.
Oh, God.
Well, if I wasn't so lazy, I'd clean my shop and then I'd start doing the show from my shop. But I'm just too lazy.
As you can see by example, you really don't have to clean to...
No, mine's 10 times that bad. I have like 500 cars just hanging from the ceiling and randomly on the floor. And
Adam, the intern, was supposed to stop by and clean out my garage, but he apparently was at some sort of event.
He texted
or something.
Me. Yeah.
I was like, "Where are you? You were supposed to be here like an hour ago." And he's like, "Oh, I'm at an event. I can't come." And I'm like, "Dude, he worked." Word intern means you're cleaning my garage. And that's before you mow my lawn.
Adam.
Exactly.
You just throw everything in the back of the truck.
Dude, it wouldn't fit.
Yeah, you'd need like a trailer and a box truck.
Yeah.
No kidding.
Totally.
And then air support.
Right. Could be it exactly. Someone says it's almost April 20th, Craig. Does that mean anything to anybody?
Like, potheads.
Like Craig? Yeah, besides the 420? Is that Craig's cue?
I'm going to a wedding on the 20th.
I don't know.
We have to change the meaning of 420 to something that involves RC.
Right. Come up with something.
Yeah, I don't know.
You could be riding on your 420s. Hell yeah.
I think the next set of hats we get, we need to have a Crazy Ramp edition.
The what?
The Crazy Ramp Builder edition.
Of hats?
Big Squid hats.
I am totally in.
Everybody needs one.
Good.
What?
We need to make flat brim hats that the brim goes all the way around the hat.
No, thank you.
Like a.
So not like a baseball hat. You want like a Crocodile Dundee hat.
A gardening hat.
No.
Yeah.
He wants. I am not wearing a gardening hat.
like a beekeeper hat or something.
All that Jim does.
It can have the little pockets so you can put your RC wrenches up there.
Tim's got one.
Tim does have one.
You can like mount a charger.
Right, an extra lipo.
Yeah.
That's a good place for your lipo in the sun on the top of your head.
Yeah.
Perfect. So what I was going to mention, the camera keeps moving around. If anybody knows any good places that do hat stuff, it took me forever to find this place, and they did an okay job, but you could only go so big on the logo and stuff. And I've seen some really cool hats where they do like the entire hat, but I can't seem to find one that'll sell me a hat under like $30 a hat, and I'm pretty sure that the people complaining that our $20 and $25 hats were expensive aren't going to pay $30 or $35. You know, by the time I get them shipped, our cost is $35. So if anybody knows a good hat place, let me know, because I will gladly make some new hats. Make it happen.
If you bought like 1,000 of them, you'd probably get them for cheaper.
Well, that's the problem. If I buy 1,000 of them, I can get a pretty good deal. But yeah, we don't really sell 1,000 hats at a time yet, so
If they were cool, you might, though.
Yeah.
Oh, there we go. The whole chicken and egg scenario. If you would have bought 1,000 hats and they were cool, you would have sold them. Well, I can't buy 1,000 hats because no one's going to buy them. Great. Thanks, Craig.
You just got to come up with a really good design.
All right. You come up with a design, and every hat over the first 100 we don't sell, you got to buy the rest of.
Mount a USB squid splitter on each hat. Have a USB thing on it.
Yeah, what's wrong with this hat? I'm going to get these hats for everybody. These are going to be the iHobby hats right here.
Do it. I'll totally wear one all weekend.
That'd be awesome. It just has Big Squid RC on the back.
Yes.
Those are our next hats. Is that a cool hat, Craig?
No.
It doesn't have horns.
The tentacles have to have built-in tools, like a different size wrench.
That'd be awesome. 2.5. You're tentacles, 2.5, 2.0. Oh, no, shoot.
Then you can have, like, one electric one that's like a drill. It's like,
Phillips. Cool. That would be cool.
Brian, the first day you start wearing a Crazy Ramp Builder edition hat, you will see how many people just freak when they see my hat.
I'm sure. If it's got horns and stuff, I am willing to bet a lot of people will freak out. I'm in. Dude, I am totally in. You got to submit that design. I'm behind it 100%.
I already got 100 of them.
All right. All right. Let's make it happen. That'd be cool.
Now we just got to make a better hat.
Yeah, right? All right, guys. Anything else going on? We're going to cut.
David says you need to talk to the armor guys and get back to us all next week with the.
I will definitely talk to the armor guys for sure. And you guys have 10 minutes. So I'm going to end the broadcast. You guys have 10 minutes. Go send in a picture to Pix at Big Squid with your address, according to Jeff. And we'll send you guys free Big Squid stickers. So go make that happen. Thanks again for watching, everybody. Thanks for hanging out with us. It's always awesome. And as always, we've got more and more people hanging out, which is really cool. We're glad to see the numbers going up. So really appreciate all your support. And definitely see you guys next week. Have a good evening. And later, guys. All right, now here's the head rocking video. Everybody's got to jump in.
Whoa.
Whoa.
Onyx batteries and chargers. Onyx sets the standard in battery power and battery charging. All the power and features you need to win.